Hey guys, Max, your intern here, and we're inside the hangar at Eli Field, and I'm here with Blade Brand Manager Derek Sachtleben.
I do.
And he's going to teach me how to fly some quads today.
Mm-hmm.
So, what are we going to fly today, Derek?
We're going to fly an Inductrix Pro, a Torrent 110, and a Theory XL.
Okay.
It should be pretty fun with a guy that hasn't really flown much, surface guy. So
I'm more of a racer than a quad flyer. So.
Mm-hmm. So what have you flown before?
I've flown an Inductrix, and I have an Inductrix Pro, but I haven't really messed with it so much because I only have a living room.
Right.
And it's kind of small, so.
No, that's plenty of space. Well, we got a big hangar here, so you have plenty of space to fly and probably crash a lot, and then we'll take it outside.
Probably.
Yeah, and then we could take it outside and fly the Torrent a little bit to kind of step up into some acro flight, and then I'm going to give him a full 5-inch race quad to fly. No self-leveling. Can't crutch on that anymore, so.
So it's okay if I crash, right?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
Break a propeller or two, that'll be a-okay.
Okay.
All
right. Just warning you.
That's fine.
It'll be interesting. So
let's do it.
All right, let's go.
All right, so what we're going to have Max fly today is the Inductrix Pro. We're going to start out on this. Now, he's flown an Inductrix before, but with this Pro here, it has a Betaflight board. What that means is that it can do like acro flight, so you can turn off self-leveling, and you can do flips and rolls. In a quad this size, it's great to learn on. Then we're going to step up to something a little bit bigger with the Torrent 110. This one has brushless motors, so it handles its outside really well. Handles wind no problem, and it's going to be quite a bit quicker than what you're going to find in a little guy like this with the brush motors. And then the final step of what we're going to do is the Theory XL. Now this is a full 5-inch race quad, big 22 series brushless motors. And yeah, this thing will do probably 75, 80, no trouble. So, you ready?
No, I'm not.
So, we'll get to this. I'm not worried about him breaking anything on this. It's full carbon fiber frame. The most he's going to do is, you know, break a propeller, but that's why they're cheap and we have plenty of those. So, should be fun.
Okay,
let's
here we
do
go.
It.
Okay. Flip your little arm.
So, Max, you've done this part before, right?
Yeah.
You've flown an Inductrix. And
I've flown the first Inductrix. I haven't flown the Pro yet. So.
Fly pretty similar?
Yeah. It's a little quicker because there's bigger there's faster motors than these, right?
Yep.
Oh, geez. Nope.
So you're familiar enough with flying FPV that this isn't intimidating for you, right?
No.
So with the self-leveling that, you know, this one has, it makes you...
I told you, I suck. Hit the gate. So what about the self-leveling?
So the self-leveling makes it so you can fly it pretty confidently, right?
Yeah.
Because you just push forward and
back
it tracks where you want it to go, right?
Yeah.
So one thing I want you to kind of practice here is a little more kind of coordinated turns. When you go into a turn with the self-leveling on, you can pretty much push forward on the pitch stick.
Yeah.
And then just kind of steer around with yaw.
Rookie here.
So while you're flying around there and self-leveling,
yeah,
what I want you to try and do is mix your yaw and your roll. So on your right stick, say you're turning left,
okay,
roll left a little bit and also yaw left. And that's going to be important when you step up to something that doesn't have self-leveling or a larger quad.
Yeah.
Because if you're pitching forward and you're flying like this and you just yaw, the craft is going to turn kind of on an odd angle, right? So you got to mix yaw and roll when you turn. So if you're rolling like this and then you yaw,
okay,
it's easier to turn that way. And it's really the only way you can turn. If you just use yaw, you're going to be looking at the sky when you get away from self-leveling.
Okay.
Throttle management. There you go. Drop it. There you go.
I'm not too good at that.
And the other thing you should remember when flying like this is you're moving forward because you're pitched forward. If you're moving a little too fast, just pitch back a little bit.
Yeah.
It'll give you time to kind of adjust and recover.
Okay.
There you go. See?
Getting slightly better.
There you go. Now you're hitting all of them. So you kind of see what I'm saying with the pitch and the the roll and the yaw?
Yeah. You definitely
You can make a lot tighter corners.
Yeah, you definitely corner better when you move both sticks.
Mm-hmm. And once you get that down, it's a lot easier to kind of step up to
acro.
To acro, because if a lot of the mistakes that people make when they first start out is they rely on that self-leveling so much that when you push forward, it almost, and a lot of crafts, you know, when you yaw, it makes it easy to turn that way.
Yeah.
So if you want to turn right and you mix both of those together, it becomes a much more controllable turn.
Oh, okay.
All right, so what we're going to have Max try now is to fly the Inductrix Pro without self-leveling and to get familiar with having to correct and orientation and everything like that before he jumps into the goggles and jumps outside to something a little bigger and powerful.
So when you give it an input, it's not going to come back to center, so you have to manually correct every kind of movement.
And it feels a lot like touchier than with self-leveling.
It is, so that's an important thing to know is without self-leveling like this, it's small movements.
Yeah.
You're going to stay in the center of the gimbal most of the time.
And is that the same once you get to bigger quads too?
It is. So once you get to bigger quads, it's going to be very minor movements. Like if you ever watch anybody fly like a larger quad, you're going to see that they don't, unless they're trying to roll or something, you don't get away from center very often. They steer really well. Most of them are powerful enough to where it doesn't take much to get them going.
Huh.
And once you're kind of in a rhythm, like go ahead and point nose out, and then kind of give it a forward movement.
Okay.
You see, it'll really keep moving, and it's just minor movements on the stick to try to keep it back.
All right, so when you're learning how to do a roll and fly a larger 5-inch quad, it's kind of a 3-step process to do a roll. So when you kind of get it to a nice hover like that, you kind of want to practice like blipping the throttle a little bit, get it to a hover state and then blip it. I don't know if you can hear that in the background. But the best way to do kind of a pinpoint roll is to blip the throttle and lower it the same time you're rolling with your right stick. So you blip the throttle and then catch it. Blip it, roll, catch. Blip it, roll, catch. I'll try to bring this close.
All right, Max. Next step on your mini quad journey is to fly a Torrent 110.
Okay.
Without self-leveling. So the mode I have it in on the transmitter right now is acro mode. So there's no self-leveling to rely on.
You kind of got it in there with the Inductrix Pro.
Yeah.
And now it's time to take it outside on a brushless setup and see what you can do.
Okay.
So go ahead and pick it up and kind of get a feel for it. And then I'm going to make you try a roll.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah, ready? Max's first roll.
All right, here we go.
Catch it. Oh.
Oh. Okay.
Catch it.
Oh,
nice.
Oh, yes. Hey guys, Max the Intern, and we're here for a little checkup out. We're still out at Eli Field, so Derek has now moved me up to the Theory XL bind and fly. So we're going to start flying that, and here we go.
Ready.
I'm not. Oh, geez. Wow, it definitely pitches a lot more than the Torrent.
Yeah, it's got a little more authority.
Yeah.
A little larger. So like I said with the everything else, just small movements.
Yeah.
Small movements on the stick.
You ready to go under the goggles?
I think so.
You got a good feel for it?
Yeah, a little bit better.
Kind of set her down nice and easy. And then kill it. There you go.
Okay.
Ready?
So it wasn't so bad. I mean, it definitely pitches a lot more than the Torrent.
It's a little faster.
So, yeah, it's a bit faster. It's got more power, so.
Oh, yeah.
All right. On to the goggles.
All right.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, take off.
There you go. Where are you going?
Kind of just floating around. Seeing the props move in front of your face.
It reminds you that you're flying something fast.
Yeah.
There you go. It made a nice throttle punch.
Oh.
It's moving, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. I'm just getting used to it.
No, it's good. You gotta get used to it. I mean, you went from never flying anything without self-leveling to flying a Theory XL Bind Fly, which is our fastest and most high performance model.
Yeah.
In what, an hour and 10 minutes total?
Something around there, yeah.
So I'd say that's about as good as it gets.
Yeah.
All right, Max, so now that you got a good feel for the Theory XL line of sight and under the goggles, we'll go ahead and go back to line of sight flying and let's see a roll.
A roll?
A roll, yep.
Okay.
Just like you did on the other two, or just like you did on the Torrent.
Okay.
Same thing, kind of blip the throttle.
Let off.
And zero then throttle, roll it with the stick, and then when it comes back level.
Catch it again?
Catch it.
Okay.
Yep.
I'll keep an eye, or I'll keep a finger on the cutoff.
Keep a finger on the disarm switch.
Yeah. Okay. Ready?
Ready.
Oh, that was awesome.
So much easier, right?
Yeah, it rolls way faster than the Torrent does.
Oh, yeah. So get out there a little bit. I don't trust you quite yet.
Oh, thanks.
Let's see another roll.
Okay.
Nice. Woo. Got a little barrel rolly there.
Yeah, I didn't.
Just remember, zero throttle.
Yeah, I forgot to let off. I'm gonna come down just a little bit. Alright.
Nice.
Wasn't bad. I had to practice kind of keep him in the center.
Mm-hmm.
I'll keep him in one spot.
Woohoo! That was good. Nice snap roll.
What about like a forward roll or a backwards roll?
You could try it.
Are those hard? You just do the same thing?
Same thing.
Okay.
Oh.
Not bad. Got a little.
Zero throttle.
It scared me a bit.
Remember where the disarm switch is. There you go.
It does float a lot more. Like when you let off the throttle, I'm afraid it's just going to like plummet to the ground. But it kind of floats up there.
Mm-hmm.
So I got to get used to that.
Carries its momentum a little bit.
Yeah.
See? You can do it with like a slow roll like that too.
Man, I feel like Steve Petrato. I'm calling you out, Steve. I'm going to call you out in a race.
You gonna start racing with this, Max?
Yeah, this is cool.
Alright.
Except I haven't put the goggles on to do rolls yet, so.
Step at a time.
Oh, geez.
What'd you think?
That was cool. That was really cool. So
first battery on a 5-inch.
Yeah.
Half of it FPV, half of it line of sight doing rolls. I'd say that's pretty darn good for first time quad pilot.
Okay.
So are you gonna tell your dad that you're not gonna be racing cars anymore?
No, I still like my cars.
All right.
Cars are still fun.
All right. Well, let's have some fun and we'll fly around a little more.
Okay.
What do you say?
I say let's go.
All right.
All right.
Clear.
All right. Am I far away from the
hangar? Yeah, you're good. Okay. Give it a roll. What was that like?
It was a little weird.
Disorienting?
No, not really. I'm not very comfortable with like telling how high and low I am. So I feel like I'm gonna hit the ground when I recover from the roll.
Oh, you won't.
No.
Like there, you're probably still 15, 20 feet off the ground.
Okay. We'll try another one here.
If you blip your throttle more, you're going to float, so you're not really going to lose any altitude. So yeah. Give it a nice punch. There you go. You actually gained height on that one.
Oh, okay.
You didn't even fall at all. You're rolling as you're moving up.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's really easy to tell when you level out with the goggles.
The orientation is a lot better.
Yeah.
You can tell if you're pitched forward a little more or pitched back.
Yeah.
You can tell where the horizon's at. Nice.
Okay, Max the intern here with Derek Sachtleben. And this is kind of the end to our day. I learned how to fly.
You did.
Sort of.
You did. No, so, that was really good. So to kind of recap, we got here and the only thing that Max had flown before was an inductrix in self-leveling mode. In a course of an hour and a half, an hour 45 minutes, we flew the inductrix. We flew a torrent with no self-leveling, and then he started flying a Theory XL Binafly, which is a full 5-inch quad, no self-leveling, doing rolls in and out of the goggles in an hour and 45 minutes. So I'd say it was a very successful day.
Okay. See, I think I'm still pretty bad because my perspective wise with the elevation is still a little off.
Yep.
So I need to work on that little fly a little bit more, but I'd say it was pretty good. I had fun.
You came a long way. A long way. You might be a quad pilot in a year or so.
I'm coming for you, Steve Petrato. Okay, so that's the end of our video. We'll have another one next week where I'm gonna learn how to fly an airplane, so that should be even more interesting because I suck at flying airplanes. I've never flown an airplane, so.
You also said you sucked at flying quads, but you only crashed once today, so.
Okay, so maybe it won't be that bad.
Mm-hmm. No pressure or anything.
Yeah.
Good luck, Allie.
All right, so we'll see you guys next time.
Thanks.
Max, in the FPV world, we call this the walk of shame.
That's in the car world, too.
Walk of shame. Walk of shame.